Good afternoon. I'm here, your instructor on Udemy, and I'm going to teach you on a course which is known as Brilliant Behavior Induction Technology. I am the founder of an institute which has evolved this technology. Now, what this technology is all about? It's about the brilliant brain, okay? And the brain which you can create yourself for the brilliance which might be there but you might not know, right? So now, since I'm a neurologist, a neuropsychologist, and I have combined behavioral sciences with the learning sciences, behavioral sciences with the brain thoughts, because the way our thoughts flow, in the same manner we have our diffused or exclusive, very expanded knowledge base, right? Every child, everyone is born very superior and very, very intelligent. But sometimes it so happens that if we are not able to control our thought, which might take us to the highest, to the pinnacle of our journey, we are not able to understand and reach to the point. Now, this technology is involved. This technology can be used by parents, counselors, psychologists, educators, principals, teachers, and the children themselves. So, like, if the children are trying to learn from the lessons I have prepared for them, there are total 5 chapters I have prepared. Okay, number 1 chapter is the lecture 1, which is understanding the mental map. Now, the mental map, what is a mental map? Like, as the map, India's map tells us about where a particular state or union territory is present, you know, the rivers and the mountains. Similarly, the mental map is the one which tells us about how our neurology flows, how our ideas flow, how our brain takes a particular message, breaks it, and receives and gives the responses. So each individual has a different mindset, you know. This mental map is based on your way of upbringing, your psychology, your family's family members' psychology, the way you have been brought up, the way your parents, your teachers have behaved with you and taught you, and there are the ways, particular ways, academic ways, psychological ways, social ways we've been set, and this is how we are very used to the norms which have been running, and we embrace them. But mind you, as each individual's mental map is unique, not all the individuals receive, break, and respond in the similar manner to the same query, to the same question. That is precisely why when a teacher teaches in a class of 60 students or more than that, many of the students understand the ideas behind the teacher's presentation, but many of them do not understand, because the kind of responses they generate after receiving the inputs in from the lecture, that's very different. So either in the first chapter, I'll teach you children that how your mental map can be developed for the best grasping of the knowledge. Okay, and also in the second chapter, you would know how to establish rapport. Now, it is very, very important for the social purpose, for academic purpose, for our future purpose, for family purpose, to establish a rapport, right? Once you establish a rapport, you will understand the people's mind very fast, you will understand what are the expectations people have from you, and what do you expect from people, and why do you expect something from those people. Now, rapport is developing good relationship. Is entirely, speaking your mind and somebody picking your mind. This is very important. It's not only for the social purpose, it's for the academic purpose too. If you want to have good friends, if you want to have good teachers, if you want to have to understand that what is expected of me, and taking yourself to a level. Okay. Now, the lecture 3 would, it would tell you about the learning styles. This is very, very important. These chapters, these 5 chapters, or the course, the total complete course which I have developed, or the technology, has taken me 8 years of research after my PhD years to develop. So, you have to have believe me that I have already tested them with more than 30,280 people whom I have trained, and 25 plus workshops I have taken physically, and also I have occupied directors and principals positions in schools and colleges. So, and pretty well, you can pretty well understand that this comes from my practical exposure to the clients, to the people, to individuals, to the organization. Now, we come to the third lecture. The third lecture is I'll teach you children to identify your learning style. You get very confused when somebody teaches you physics, chemistry, social studies, and you are not able to learn the way your neighbor has learned, and you really wonder, why am I not able to understand when she is able to understand? Was there, maybe that she is very intelligent. What do you say? You say, oh, she or he is very intelligent, I am not. No, it's not that. You got a special learning style, the way you have special mental map. Similar way, you have special learning style of anything. That means the way you absorb the information. Okay, and I'll dictate you, I'll tell you, and teach you through videos and the 17 pages long course lectures I have feeded in the course. So you will understand that how to understand your learning style and get very easy sailing through the course you learn. Not only the course or the studies you do, anything which you would like to learn, you will see that how easy, how it has become a cakewalk for you to learn, understand, or absorb the knowledge. Okay, now this lecture 4, this after this lecture 3rd is lecture 4th, which is very, very near to my very, very close to my heart. I have taken this life skills for children, which are never taught neither in schools nor in colleges. And what are life skills? Understanding, problem solving, communicating well, presenting your mind, knowing what you want in your life, goal setting, and managing your emotions, anger control, presentation, talking to people, so social behavior. I mean, there are thousands, and I'm not going to teach you thousands of those ones, but the two most important life skills which I have learned through my 28 years of experience in education, I have understood that there are two very, very important ones. There is number one, concentration for academics, okay? And number two is anger control. If you concentrate, learn to concentrate, how to concentrate, and understand, get into the depth of the things, and also controlling your rapid anger, you got to achieve the goals you have fixed for yourself, right? And getting to the understanding your goals is at the first place is very important. Now, the last lecture, lecture 5, would teach you about the memory and intelligence boosting. My God, this chapter has taken my life to develop. Like this course, this 5th lecture is very, very important, because since I'm an NLP master practitioner, I have induced these NLP techniques with behavioral sciences and academics, and taught very specific 5 to 7 techniques that how can your memory become excellent, super, and you can have super memory skills, exam skills, reading and writing. And after you have got this, you are destined to reach at the pinnacle of academics. Not only academics, you will see that you will strive for only success. Then I usually call it the only success program, right? But for the matter of it, I have named this program Brilliant Behavior Induction Technology. It's a technology, and all these lectures have been based on this technology. I wish you best luck, that whosoever is willing to work on itself first and then reach to the goal it has set for itself. And once you have set the goals, you will reach through these technologies. Specifically, when I have put my intentions very clearly on almost all the facets of learning. Okay, God bless you. Meet you at Udemy. Bye-bye.